Good morning. It's 10 o'clock. I'm Clifford Chu, and it's time for the Easy News on ICRT. The TIEX opened up 39 points this morning from yesterday's close at 82.87 on turnover of 1.8 billion NT. China Trust Financial Holdings is reportedly close to purchasing the Brother Elephants baseball team. The team was put up for sale at the end of last season by current owners, the Brother Hotel. Although the final bid has not been made public, sources say China Trust Financial offered the highest bid among those interested parties. The name of the top bidder is expected to be announced on November 29th. China Trust last owned a baseball team from between 1996 to 2008 when it financed the China Trust Whales. China's top negotiator with Taiwan arrived on the island heading a trade delegation yesterday for an 8-day visit. Associated of Relations Across the Taiwan Straits chairman, Chen Deming, was greeted at Taoyuan International Airport by Straits Exchange Foundation vice chairman Gao Kanglian and anti-China protesters. Speaking briefly to reporters on his arrival, Chen said he wants to feel the heartbeat of the island and enjoy its beauty. It is the first time that Chen has visited Taiwan since assuming his new post in April. President Ma Ying-jeou yesterday said China's establishment of an air defense identification zone in the East China Sea does not involve the territorial sovereignty. According to Ma, there is a small overlap with Taiwan's identification zone, but that will have no impact on the ability of the island's armed forces to conduct exercises in the area. It was the first time that Ma has commented on Beijing's air defense identification zone since it was announced on Saturday. The Central Weather Bureau says a cold air mass will arrive on the island later today. The mercury in the north is predicted to drop to as low as 10 degrees through tomorrow and into the weekend. Forecasters say the strongest continental cold air mass of the year will also affect the south, pushing temperatures down to the 12 degrees in the Kaohsiung area. The cold front is expected to last from early tomorrow until Sunday evening and possibly early Monday through in the north and center. Honduras' newly elected president named in his transition team yesterday, while about 200 students protested and demanded a recount of the vote. Juan Orlando Hernandez, the ruling National Party's candidate, has not spoken publicly since just after the election on Sunday. However, he released a statement that included the names of those who will help him take over the government from the current president. Hernandez, 45, has all but won the hotly contested presidential race, with electoral authorities describing his lead as irreversible. His main competitor, Xiomara Castro, has challenged the official returns and claimed victory. Hernandez has 34% of the votes to 29% of the vote for Castro in an 8-candidate field, with about a third of the votes still uncounted. Silvio Berlusconi pulled his Forza Italia's party support from the government on yesterday, the eve of a Senate vote to kick the media magnate out of parliament due to his tax fraud conviction. Berlusconi said he would move into the opposition if the Senate votes to strip him of his seat. The vote is scheduled for Wednesday, and most analysts expect him to be removed from his post. The stability of the government of President Enrico Letta wasn't expected to be affected in the short term, but Letta will see just what his new numbers are in the confidence vote on the annual budget that was being held overnight. Pope Francis denounced the financial global system that excludes the poor as he issued the mission statement for his papacy yesterday. In the text of a 224-page document released yesterday, Francis denounced trickle-down economic theories as unproven and naive, saying they are based on a survival of the fittest mentality with no regard for ethics, the environment, or God. The Pope also decried the Church's obsession with rules and doctrine and said in some cases the Church's old customs can be cast aside if they no longer serve to communicate the faith. CBS ordered 60 Minutes correspondent Lara Logan and her producer to take a leave of absence yesterday following a critical internal review of their handling of the show's October story on the Benghazi raid based on a report on a supposed witness whose story can't be verified. Questions were quickly raised about whether the man was lying, something 60 Minutes should have better checked out before airing the story, according to a report from an executive at the station. The report also said Logan should not have done the story in the first place after making a speech in Chicago a year ago, claiming that it was a lie that America's military had tamed al-Qaeda. And now looking at the weather across Taiwan, according to the Central Weather Bureau, we can expect mostly cloudy skies and occasional rain across much of the north, with a high of 24 in Taipei, partly cloudy skies in the center, with a high of 25 in Taizong, and partly clear skies in the south, with a high of 26 in Kaohsiung. Current temperatures are Taipei 22, Taizong 22, Kaohsiung 24. That's it for the Easy News today. Remember, you can download a slower version of the news, as well as a transcript with Chinese explanations on our website, www.icrt.com.tw. Just look for Easy News. Enjoy the rest of your morning. I'm Clifford Chu.